keeping them honest on bullying in America. Yet again, another teen has taken his own life, according to his parents, after being bullied for years. A 14-year-old boy this time. Time and time again on this program, we've reported on the problem of bullying in this country, and time again, we've announced the deaths of children. Children who should not be dead. Children whose loneliness and desperation, not just in the last few minutes of their life, but often in the years leading up to their deaths, is simply heartbreaking to imagine. This is Jamey Rodemeyer, just 14 years old, a freshman at Williamsville North High School in Buffalo, New York. Jamey routinely blogged about his troubles. Just 11 days ago, he wrote something online. He said, "I always say how bullied I am, but no one listens. What do I have to do so people will listen?" 1 week later, this past Sunday, Jamey committed suicide. Now, often when kids die, there's no record of their pain. There's no record of what they've been through, of their suffering. But Jamey did leave us a message. Months ago, he posted a message on YouTube as part of the It Gets Better project, a program to spread messages of hope to suicidal lesbian, gay, and bisexual children. Even in his sadness, Jamey was reaching out to help others. This is Jamey Rodemeyer in his own words.
Hi, this is Jamey from Buffalo, New York, and I'm just here to tell you that it does get better. Here's a little bit of my story. December 2010, I thought I was bi, and then I always got made fun of because I virtually have no guy friends, and I only have friends that are girls, and it bothered me because people would be like, "Faggot, fag," and they'd taunt me in the hallways, and I felt like I could never escape it, and I made a form spring, which I shouldn't have done, and people would just constantly send me hate, telling me that gay people go to hell.
Jamey says he constantly got messages, hate messages, on the social networking site Formspring, which is a site which allows kids to send anonymous messages to each other. But back then, as you hear, he says he rose above the negativity. Here's more of what Jamey had to say.
And I just want to tell you that it does get better, because when I came out for being bi, I got so much support from my friends, and it made me feel so secure. And then, if your friends or family isn't even there for you, I look up to one of the most supporting people of the gay community that I think of, that I know, Lady Gaga. She makes me so happy, and she lets me know that I was born this way. And that's my advice to you from her, that you were born this way. And all you have to do is hold your head up, hold your head up, and you'll go far. Because that's all you have to do. Just love yourself and you're set.
Love yourself and you're set. And now here's the last part of his message, perhaps the most chilling.
I promise you will get better. I have so much support from people I don't even know online. I know that sounds creepy, but they're so nice and caring, and they don't ever want me to die.
They don't ever want me to die. Jamey Rodemeyer, last May. Last Sunday, he took his own life. He was 14 years old. Now, we do know at Jamey's school they did have some type of bullying prevention program. It's unclear how extensive it was. A lot of schools across the country have programs like that, and more states are enacting new anti-bullying laws for schools. But there are some organizations and lawmakers who say all of this isn't needed. Organizations like Focus on the Family, who say some anti-bullying efforts are actually just ways to promote a so-called gay agenda. Candy Cushman, an education analyst for the group, posted this on truetolerance.org. Quote, "What parents need to be aware of is there are activist groups who want to promote homosexuality to kids because they realize if they can capture hearts and minds of our children at the earliest ages, they will have, for all practical purposes, won the clash of values that we are currently experiencing." Then there's Robert Newman, head of the California Christian Coalition. His group is planning to fight new legislation signed by Governor Jerry Brown that adds sexual orientation to the state's existing anti-discrimination laws and compels schools to teach lesbian and gay and transgendered history alongside history of other ethnic and minority groups. Here's Mr. Newman, what he said this past weekend about bullying at the California Republican Party Convention in Los Angeles. We found this on thinkprogress.org.
It's part of growing up. It's part of maturing. It's not something with which I engaged. I grew up in a Christian home. I didn't engage in that kind of behavior. People were people. We knew they were unusual behaviors. But we went on with life.
But did you?
I hardly think that bullying is a real issue in schools. There's no reason to have a special bill for, let's say, 3% of the population, period.
Well, Newman is not alone in that thinking. In Kentucky, House Bill 370 would prohibit bullying because of a student's sexual orientation, race, or religion. A state lawmaker named Mike Harmon is fighting the bill. Listen.
Someone, you know, just in conversation said, well, you know, I think homosexuality is a sin. Well, we don't want that child to be bullied because they have a certain moral or religious belief, and we don't want, certainly don't want them to be labeled a bully just because they have that particular belief.
And let's not forget the civil rights investigation going on in Minnesota's largest school district, Anoka-Hennepin, outside Minneapolis. The U.S. Justice Department is investigating several incidents involving bullying and harassment. The community is embattled in a culture war over homosexuality in the classroom.